Morning and welcome to the first full day in Walt Disney World, and we're going to Epcot today. It is 5 something a.m. Obviously jet lag. I'm the type of person that when I'm up, I'm up. I'm a morning person. So because I've had my owner's lockers delivered last night, which is the thing that I have in Florida that allows me to kind of like keep some stuff when I come out here. Like my American hair straighteners, some toiletries that are like full size and etc. If you want more information about that, check out my DVC series that I did with my friend Rachel in May, and we stayed at Wilderness Lodge. I talk about it more in that. I've got a tripod in there basically, and I'm wondering if I set my phone up, I might be able to get like a nice time lapse of the sun rising. My alarm is going off, 6:58, which means I have, Taylor Swift! Okay, it means I've got 2 minutes to get ready for the drop of the virtual queue. So I'm gonna show you the process. Now, I have showed how to do this in previous vlogs many, many times, but I'll just give you a very quick overview. Basically, I like to go to time.is, which is a website that allows you to see like the military time, like exactly what time it is. So it's counting down to the seconds. And basically, when it hits exactly 7 a.m., that's when you want to kind of refresh. The app opens up here, and we're going to scroll down to virtual queues, join virtual queue. Epcot, confirm your party, just me, and you're gonna refresh it at exactly 7 a.m. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Group 16! Look at that! And it sounds silly, but that 1 second can make the world a difference. So, buzzing. 16, brilliant. I'm also gonna get Genie Plus for today because they have changed the pricing. So if I go to purchase for today on the tip board, it will then take me to the prices for each park, or if I want to go to all parks. So if I wanted a park hop today, it would cost me $27. Oh my goodness, that's expensive. Or just Magic Kingdom is $27. Epcot, however, is only $19. So that's the second cheapest. Not too shabby. First thing in the morning with Genie Plus, when you're on the tip board, it would normally show you times, but I don't know if you can see it. It actually says check availability. And the reason it does that, is it gonna focus? There you go. The reason it does that is because in going through to the next page where you confirm your party and it gives you a specific time to book, the time will probably already have gone because everyone's booking things so quickly. What I like to do is go to confirm party, go to the next page where it says, this is the time that you can book. And Frozen Ever After was coming up at 12:45 for me. I was like, that's a long time to wait and to use my first lightning lane of the day when I've paid, you know, $19. So I go back to confirm your party, continue, go forward, it gives you a new time. And I do that back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And the hope is that in that process, somebody in the Walt Disney World cancels their reservation, and it worked because I managed to get 9:45 for Frozen Ever After just by going back and forth. So winning! I find that Genie Plus works a lot better when I'm by myself, and it's sometimes the case that when I'm traveling with other people, we won't bother with Genie Plus because, you know, trying to get 4 or 5 people into one reservation is a lot more difficult than just me who can flip in, because even if there's a party of 2 that cancel, I can probably get one of those lightning lanes and stuff. So yeah, I don't mind it. I was trying to justify it to myself, but I'm on holiday, so I don't really care. I appreciate if you're new to Disney vlogs or you're prepping for Walt Disney World and you have no idea what Genie Plus is. This is all very overwhelming and very complicated to understand. Believe me, I know. If you want more information, I do have a guidebook, which looks like this. It's my dream guide, an unofficial guide to Walt Disney World. And in this, I basically give you all the information you need to know about Genie Plus. I do my best to break it down in like the simplest terms possible. And this is the thing, Even just trying to understand what is Disney Genie, what is Disney Genie Plus, what is a lightning lane, you know, what's happened to Fast Pass, what is, like, all these things, I answer those in the book. So if you are planning a trip and you just want to understand how to get Genie Plus, how to use it, what it is, the book's available on Amazon and also on my website, adamhattan.com. Speaking of adamhattan.com, on Friday, when this vlog goes out, my Christmas morning jumper is going on general sale, which looks like this. I made the design a bit more subtle this year in order to make it available to wear all year round. But it's a lovely garment, really nice and thick, lovely and soft. It's embroidered, but and then there's also some other things that we do. This, I have news for this later on in this series, so stay tuned. But there's some of the other products you can buy. This is normally the one that goes the quickest, the dusty pink hoodie. I love it. Hair did, sun cream did. And on that note, I was watching one of my vlogs back to kind of like see what I'd filmed previously, and I noticed that I kept talking about the sun cream that you can buy at Disney, this one. So I used to talk about this a lot, and reasons being it goes on quite nicely, it's a clear one, and obviously it's factor 50, so if you have sensitive skin like myself, then it worked really well. However, I've come to realize that, like, my clothes, certainly around the neck kind of stuff like that, they were either starting to get like a colored tinge on them, like white t-shirts starting to get like a colored tinge, or they just had like a bit of a weird smell, it was almost like a damp smell. But it wasn't damp, it was just like, I don't know. So it's obviously the chemicals in this. So I've switched away from that one and gone to the Boots sensitive and allergy one. It's a 30. The sun is shining, it is now 7:45 and the park opens at 8:30 a.m. For early entry. So basically if you're staying in a Disney resort or a Good Neighbor hotel, which are typically the ones in Disney Springs area, you can actually enter the park 30 minutes before the park actually opens, which would be handy. And hopefully go on Guardians first, and I've got Frozen Ever After coming up shortly after that, and I'm just... Oh, and Moana Journey of Water, that's here now as well! So, yeah, cool. Let's just go to Disney World! I'm in Disney World. Let's go to Epcot. Here is the theme park transportation.
B.
Best believe it. I love that noise. The only thing I'm mindful of at this resort is that because it's such a big resort, the buses go to like the stop round that way first and they go all the way around the resort, and if they're full, they're full. So if it's really busy here, what I might do is walk over to the first bus stop because it's not that far, and it also means that you're guaranteed to get on and I can get my little seat at the back that I'm tucked in the corner. As suspected, the Epcot stop is very, very busy. There's a whole busload of people there, which gives me the impression that there's probably been a few buses that have come and not picked people up. So that's the only downside about the bigger resorts, is that if there's multiple bus stops, it can be that you're waiting a long time and you're just watching buses go past. But for, like, I'm not in a rush this morning, I've got plenty of time to get there. But it'd be nice to, you know, get on a bus without waiting and worrying about whether or not I'm going to get on it. Because that's when my travel anxiety kicks in. And I know that I'm going to get there, and I know it's not an issue, but my brain just goes somewhere else. Even though it looks very, very big on the map, and don't get me wrong, this is a big resort, the walk is probably 5 minutes, if that. You know, if you're staying at the back of Pop Century, you'd probably end up walking this distance as well. This bus stop is located in the Casitas area, which are all the buildings that are kind of like one continuous building. And it's between 3 and 4 past the pool, by what I can see. That's the good thing about Coronado Springs as well. Even staying in the Gran Destino Tower, you can still use all the quiet pools. And I find the quiet pools are actually more enjoyable than the main pool a lot of the time. Because if you get it at the right time of the day, you can pretty much have it yourself. This is what the bus stops look like around the resort, but these service all 4 theme parks. So even if it looks busy, consider that's everyone for 4 theme parks, not just one. Epcot! Hooray! And it's an Incredibles bus. This is how full the bus is after the first stop. So I can imagine after 2 more stops, it will probably be a full, and it probably might not even pick up from the front. Looks like I timed it perfectly, and going to that first bus stop was definitely the right move. At the main bus stop where the Gran Destino Tower is, some people got on, but not a lot. Not the whole group that was waiting. We're here!
Thank you.
Okay, early entry, this way. Early entry from 8:30 a.m. to 9 a.m. It's going to be all the way down to the right hand side of the entranceway. There's a little sign here that says, early entry, guests are participating resorts or with breakfast reservations. Oh, that's good to know. So if you potentially booked yourself into Akershus or something. Since I've got early entry and Moana is right there, I'm thinking this could be the prime opportunity to do it. Even though it's a water attraction, I don't think you get particularly wet unless you choose to. And it'd be nice to show it first and get it out of the way. And I haven't got my return time for Guardians come up yet. So this is just across from the seas with Nemo and friends. Moana, Journey of Water. Hi.
Hi.
Oh, this is cool. I'm getting emotional, like the music's really like getting to me. Touch the strings of water. Yes sign, I will. I feel like I think we're doing this a lot. I like the detail of it, it's very nice, like the little waterfall up there. I didn't really know what to expect, but this feels like a really immersive water park. Like, I don't know, it's got a really nice vibe about it. Stand on the splash and wave to the stream in front of you, okay? I'm waving. Faster, oh God. Ah, okay, cool. Oh, that's cute. Oh, okay. Brenda's telling me I need to look for characters. The hook? Is that one? Oh, he's underneath it. Oh, okay, cool. Follow the footsteps. Yes. Follow the footsteps.
Follow.
Ah, that's cool. I like that, thank you.
Yeah, so keep looking.
Yeah, I will do. Just spoke to the very lovely Brenda, and she was saying you have to come back at night because it's a whole different experience. So, the music is the thing that's really getting me. It's so, like, lively and everything like that. So, if there's any Imagineers watching who knows who did the music, please just tell them I love it. This has actually, you know, really sold the experience for me so far. Stand on the splash and hold out your arm. Ooh, that's cool. I love that it goes exactly to where your hand is. Ah, that's so cool. I really didn't know what to expect with this, but I'm actually really enjoying it. There's Pua, my favorite. And now entering land. If you move slowly, this waterfall might open for you. Okay, doing that with my camera was nerve-wracking, but it opened. That's cool. I'm not sure it would work going backwards, so I'm not even going to try it. There's restrooms here. I don't know if that's just like a shortcut outside to where restrooms are outside of here, but handy. Lake. All water is connected. This little lake is continually being refilled by water coming from different sources. Oh look! I didn't even spot her. Oh, this is so cute. The thing that really got me going was listening to like all the families like interacting and everything. And this is exactly what Disney's about. Like getting families to enjoy each other's company and everything like that. I just heard like a little girl playing with it and I was like, oh my god. Yeah, yeah, okay, I like it. The detail on her is amazing. I love it. Wow. It's like they just took inspiration from like the Fountains Outside Journey to Imagination with Figment, also a bit of Alice in Wonderland in Disneyland Paris. The theming of the rock work is really good. It's really long. Like, you could easily spend like 20 minutes in here if you had like a family of kids and everything. There's like a splash pad area. Very cute. Oh, look, the little coconut people. And they're spitting water as well. Should we do it together?
Yeah!
1, 2, 3. No, it wasn't that great. So you need to work as a group on this one. Oh my god. Like, Everyone's smiling, having fun. Jump on the water, okay. Oh, this one's a bit leery. Okay, now. Nice. Moana Journey of Water, 5 out of 5. Like, I love Imagineering, I love all the history of Disney, and I love the reasons why the parks were made and everything like that, and what Walt's vision was, and that Walt would love that. That's what I appreciated about it. And yeah, just hearing everybody enjoying it and everybody was smiling and having a great time. Obviously it was quite quiet in the morning, so it might be a good time to do it, but yeah. Yeah, the only reason it didn't get 5-star plus is I think it probably would have fit better in Epcot, no, Animal Kingdom. But all in all, loved it. Hello baby. Rope drop is happening in 10 minutes. You might just be able to see the crowd of people back there. I don't really have a strategy today. I'm just kind of here for the vibes and the good times. I've just cut through the eatery. Do I want a Starbucks now? I'm a bit hungry. I'll do Guardians before coffee. I think that's a wise decision. Thank you. Whilst I'm heading through the queue, I'm just doing a cast compliment on the app for Tony. So you can just go into the bottom three lines on the right and then select cast compliment. You choose what they did, what location they're in, their name, and then you can choose the date of the interaction and submit it. Thank you for taking the time to share your magic with our cast. We'll be sure to pass it on.
Greetings, Terrans. I am Nova Prime Irani Rayan, commander of the Nova Corps.
Terrans, this is Centurion Merrick again. We're having a little bit of trouble with our ship's airlock, and it appears we need to open it manually. Now, no one has... Oh, we got it! You're good to go! Let's do this!
In my world is thing of the copyright. Even though we're at the exit and there's a song playing, it's still copyrighted. As a general rule of thumb with Genie Plus, typically you'll only be able to hold one reservation at a time. So you've either got to use the reservation that you've already got, or Disney will allow you to book another one if your reservation's really far in the day, after a 2-hour cooling off period, as it were. But my biggest tip in trying to get the most out of Genie Plus, try and get your first reservation
as early as you can, which is what I've done with Frozen at 9:45, and then go and use that straight away. So at 9:45, once I've gone through the second tap and it's gone ba-ding, then I can book another one. So that by the time that I've got out of riding Frozen and walk to my next location, hopefully I won't be far off using my next reservation. So if you use it the right way, you could potentially get, you know, 8 uses out of it, and I think there's 8 attractions in Epcot or thereabouts that you can use Genie Plus on. So that's Test Track. Typically I find Test Track is the hardest ride to get on any day, either with Genie Plus or without, because the wait time is always long.
Yeah.
You think it's the first hour of the morning, it's already an hour long. And with Genie Plus, those reservations go very quickly. The ride gets shut down a lot if there's like thunderstorms in the area and stuff like that, so then they have like a backup of Genie Plus. So my advice, Test Track. Try and do it if you're coming from Rope Drop, first thing. You typically won't be waiting very long. And then also it's out of the way, it's done, so if there's any storms later in the day, not going to affect your ride. I'm living for the vibes this morning. I don't know what it is, everyone's in a really good mood. I've had a few nice interactions with guests, like in lines and stuff. Someone complimented my shirt. There's also a little girl behind me who was riding Guardians for the first time, and I was kind of like helping the mum big her up, being like, you can do this, it's your birthday, you're gonna have a great time. And yeah, and also Journey of Water, that was a really Disneyfying, just feel the vibes, you know, just feel the magic, feel the, oh, we're Disney World. Oh, okay, you won't see it on camera, so I'm not gonna bother showing you just yet, but they've just started installing the floats for the new fireworks show. These look a lot less intrusive than the previous barges for Harmonious, and that hopefully they take them off the lagoon during the day. They look a lot lighter and easier to navigate. They don't look like they've been fixed in a location, so hopefully that is the case, but they're a lot more subtle than what the tacos were. Don't get me wrong, I did love Harmonious, I just didn't love the big black things being there in the middle of the day. I do find October is typically the best weather. It's also the highest probability that you're going to have a hurricane as well, so bear that in mind. There does seem to be a couple of rain clouds around. I'm hoping I can dodge them today because I didn't bring my raincoat with me because I thought I would be clever and just check the weather, which never works in my favour, but you know, you live and learn. I just saw an elderly couple sat on the bench sharing a school bread from Norway. I want that when I'm a pensioner, sat on a bench sharing a school bread with my Flynn rider. I love this place. It looks like it's about to tip it down.
Hi. Do you want to build a snowman? Come on, I know you do. Elsa's made a magic winter show with summer snow for spending. We're going up to Elsa's ice house with you. Elsa's Ice Palace?
I just had another, like, I'm here. I'm having such a good day. Like, I'm grinning from ear to ear all the time. Definitely my favourite park. This is my home park, and just love it. The Grand Fiesta Tour is always really, really quiet first thing in the morning, and this is like my favourite ride to do solo. Don't know why, just is. I just like the vibes. It's worth noting this attraction is fully wheelchair accessible because they have a boat that a wheelchair can drive onto. So if, for example, someone's in a wheelchair they can't get out of, they can still ride. First priority now is going to be food. I'm gonna go to Starbucks, get myself a little breakfast sandwich, a little coffee to get me started, and then I've booked Spaceship Earth, which I managed to book for right away, which is good. And the good thing is that even though they give you like an hour window to use it, they're a bit more gracious after the time than they are before the time. So if you turn up like 10 minutes late, they're more than likely still going to let you in. They have now said that the 50th statues are staying. I personally don't think that anything for the 50th should be staying beyond the 50th, because then the 50th becomes less special, and like the next event would be less special as well. But you know, I'm a sucker for a plain canvas. I love Disney World when it's just Disney World as a whole, and they haven't really had that for a long time. Not since the pandemic, anyway. Now, they said that World Celebration, which is this walled-off area here, this should be ready by the end of the year, and it looks like all the trees are in. So hopefully that is the case. Is it end of the year? Beginning of next year? I lose track. It's looking nice and green, nice and luscious behind those walls. Hopefully it's just a case of pouring the concrete and then it can open up to guests. That's a nice shot, isn't it? Spaceship Earth amongst the trees. I like that. Ooh, a magnet, you say? If you're an annual pass holder, they will scan your magic band, ask to see your photo ID, and then you get a free magnet. How cute is that? I got the Mickey and Minnie one for the 50th, so this is quite nice. Okay, the wait does look quite long, but at the same time, I need my caffeine fix, so I'm just gonna grin and bear it. No, it doesn't say how much. My favorite game. I think I'm gonna get this breakfast sandwich, but this Corona looks amazing. I've gone for a double chocolatey chip creme frappuccino with light ice. Also, if you come to this side, loads of seating. Around the other side, it is full.
For your safety, remain seated with your hands on your feet and legs inside the vehicle.
Since the dawn of recorded history, we've been inventing the future one step at a time. So let's travel back in time together. I'll show you how our ancestors created the world we know today. And then it will be your turn to create the world of tomorrow. At this point, each civilization has its own form of writing, which none of the others can understand. But the Phoenicians, who trade with all of them, have a solution. They create a simple common alphabet, adaptable to most languages. Remember how easy it was to learn your ABCs? Thank the Phoenicians. They invented them. Rome built the first World Wide Web, and it's leading us into the future.
Now, if you really like the burning Rome smell, as you're coming through this archway, there is a hole in the wall on the right-hand side. You might not be able to see it on the vlog, but you want to face this way and give a good... Oh, that's the good stuff. Hidden Mickey! Now, animatronics are obviously very expensive to make, so Disney tends to recycle their animatronics when they need to. So there's two animatronics just here on the left. These are actually recycled animatronics of the dad and I think the daughter from the Carousel of Progress. And if you look at their faces, you can really tell.
We've just paused in a perfect opportunity to tell you about a fun fact.
This little boy here selling newspapers, he used to be a lot closer to the ride and facing the attraction. But people kept trying to snatch the newspaper out of his hands, and his face was looking a bit worse for wear. So now he faces the wall, or rather, down the street.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
After 30,000 years of time travel, here we are, a truly global community, poised to shape the future of this. Our spaceship Earth. Let's have some fun creating the future, shall we? On your computer screen, answer a few questions for us. Then we'll show you a new world, custom made just for you. Ready?
Future is green. Your car runs on environmentally friendly fuels, and your green home conserves and generates its own energy. The end, or should I say, the beginning of your future.
I mentioned earlier that I thought Moana Journey of Water might have been better in Animal Kingdom, and whilst I do stand by that, I do like the fact that they've added more nature to Epcot. With the way the world is going and becoming more eco-friendly and that kind of stuff, I do understand that the future is looking greener, if you know what I mean. So I like the fact that they are incorporating more nature into the park, and the center looks like it's going to be really luscious and really green and lovely. So I'm looking forward to coming back next year and seeing what it looks like with all the walls down and the Epcot of the future finally debuted. Moana is meeting guests here now. Very cool. Oh my goodness, it's looking a lot busier now. The Seas with Nemo Friends is currently going through a bit of an exterior refurbishment, so I think they're doing a bit of painting. You've noticed that the seagulls are not there right now, but I think they're just being repaired. And they're doing some work on the mosaic? Mural at the back. I managed to get a lightning lane for Soarin', but it's now Soarin' Over California. So they've changed it back as like a part of the 100th anniversary celebration. And I can't tell you how excited I am to just smell the orange groves again. So they've changed out all the smells, they've changed out the film, and it's gonna be nice to see the original and kind of compare and see what I feel. Let's do this. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it now. So you see they put a sticker over around the world, and they've got a Disney 100 little plaque there to show that this is a limited time thing.
Thank you.
My name is Patrick, and I'll be your chief flight attendant today. We'll begin boarding in a few minutes, but first I'd like to acquaint you with some important safety information. When the doors to your flight open, please take a seat and store all carry-on items in the underseat compartment. This includes cameras, purses, hats, and of course, these little beauties.
Soaring over California was really good. I really enjoyed it. Considering that I like thought I would probably never ride it again, it's really nice to do it and just have a bit of nostalgia. And I think if you're probably comparing it in terms of like a first time viewing, I think Around the World does have the edge. But if you're a long time Disney Parks goer and you remember that one fondly, it's well worth enjoying whilst you can. I don't know how long it's going to be here for, but they said it's like a limited time thing, so get over here if you can. Little Chippendale pumpkins up there. Cute. Heading on to World Showcase, this little bit between the Canada Food and Wine stand and the railings here is a bit of a pinch point, so just be mindful. Don't worry, the whole showcase doesn't look like this. I would like to get the Canadian cheddar and bacon soup, but this is a Saturday, so it's pretty busy. I might try and do it later on in the trip when I'm here during the week, and probably first thing as well. This is just something to note, Epcot during the Food and Wine Festival, don't come on a Saturday. I've come on a Saturday because I'm not planning to stay here for the afternoon, evening. That's when it gets really, really busy. People start arriving about lunchtime and then we'll just stay here for the whole night. So if you're gonna come on a Saturday, maybe just duck out before it gets really crazy. Best time to come on the evenings is when they've either got the extended evening hours if you're in a deluxe resort, which is on a Monday evening at the moment, or potentially just any weekday, as long as it's not a Friday. My friends Brooke and Tommy have said that they're going to be able to join for lunch, so I'm just going to pop into guest relations to see if they can actually modify the reservation to include them, because it won't let me do it on the app because we're less than 2 hours out. Worst case scenario, you can just ask at the restaurant.
Thank you.
They can't modify it in guest relations, but he did say if you pop over early to the restaurant, they should be able to modify it for you. Or if they can't modify it for the same time, they'll let you know like what time you might need to come back in order to accommodate everybody.
Hi.
Turn you down.
Thank you.
Whilst I'm here, it never hurts to have a moo moo shiroo. A new sketchbook ornament with the Walt statue that they're adding to World Celebration. That's cool. How much is that? $26.99. Ooh. What is this? Is it like a figure? Oh, does it light up? Shut up. It does light up, but either the battery's dead in the display or it's just too bright, but it's $125. Sorry. It's lovely, it really is, but it's quite heavy. And yeah, I don't know. It's a bit spenny. Just spoke to the very nice cast member at the front. He said, yep, no problem, just come back and let us know you want to have two people when you check in. That was easy. Whilst I'm waiting for Brooke and Tommy to come here, I think I'm gonna go into the shop because I need some air con. It's a bit warm today. That's better. These backpacks are so cute. How much? $79.95.
I think you could switch, you know, with your environment and set out.
They've got the socks here that are like designed for flip-flops. How much are they? $8.95. Well, that's not too bad. Does anyone else remember that they used to have these sweets that would hang down from the stands? They were like individually packaged little ball sweets. I used to love them. Why don't they do this anymore? I want them.
this kawaii Japan's cute culture exhibition is the optimum place to just sit in aircon. Great, yeah, I'll go over there. Thank you. So, Shikisai and friends. This is the menu. It's predominantly sushi, but they do have some items that are not sushi, which is good for Brooke because she's not a fan. Have you already decided what you fancy?
So the avocado roll, because I do like that kind of sushi.
Oh, okay.
We like karage chicken. We've had that at other Japanese restaurants.
This is the Japanese potato salad. It smells amazing. It's obviously the bacon on there. And then this is the chicken. Dig in, everybody. Japanese potato salad. I'll give that a 4 out of 5. The chicken... 2. What are you saying?
2.
Oh, like a scale of 1 to 10? Oh. 1.5.
Oh, for the chicken.
Yeah.
The potato salad is nice. It's not warm, but it's refreshing. Thank you.
Thank you.
What's this?
The beef yaki udon.
Beef yaki udon.
Yes. So beef and vegetables.
And udon.
A vegetable tempura there.
Yeah. We've got eggplant. Looks like asparagus. Pumpkin, mushrooms, onion.
We've each been given a bookmark as a souvenir, which is very cute. And then they also gave us this stamp. Because the restaurant is based on the four seasons, we've come in autumn. If you come in the other seasons, apparently you can then get a special prize or a special gift, souvenir. She didn't say free meal though. I think overall, I didn't really enjoy the food that I ordered. It might be, I think if you're a really, really adventurous eater, you would love this place.
Are you a more adventurous sushi eater though? Like if you got different sushi,
I think I should have ordered like a California roll or something.
Yeah.
I think based on the food that I ordered and the cost, 2 out of 5. But the service was good. What do you guys think?
Service was excellent.
Yeah, I'd say like...
I'm a little bit lower on the rating scale. 1.5.
Oh, wow.
So I'm doing a 10-point grade scale. I'm doing 3 out of 10.
I think... I was going to say 3 because I really liked her waitress. She was really nice.
Yeah, she was really good.
Food quality and taste. I really liked the avocado roll. And I liked our new
I'll put up the 2 out of 5. The udon was very good.
So are you going 3?
No, I'll do 2.
2?
Yeah.
Okay. That's a nice atmosphere. It's a lovely view. Don't get me wrong. But yeah, I mean, you're paying a lot of money for it. I don't know. It might be right for you. Worth looking at a menu to try. Hi. Not a day to get a margarita. That's what I think. Not a day to get a margarita. It'd be rude to come to Epcot and not go in the creation shop, especially with Brooke here. The queen of all things Disney merch.
all the time.
Oh, aircon.
Really great.
Thank you. Oh, that's quite fun. I don't love Marvel enough to buy it, but it's very cute. They have the bird from Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway that you can put a little magnet on your shoulder and he'll sit on your shoulder. How much is this? Oh, no price, my favorite game.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, okay. $24.99. You can keep it. $29.99. Oh, I love that. Is that lucky? Oh, Figment! Oh, that's cute. That's quite funny. Stitch is a spider. How much? $34.99. Bye. Be your own kind of magic. Oh, that's Hocus Pocus 2. So the old witches, the new witches. Nice. So nice to see Brooke and Tommy. We've just said our goodbyes.
I'm gonna duck out of the park because it's crazy busy right now. Me and Jesse have planned to meet up to go shopping whilst Sam and Dale have got like a date night planned. So I think I'm probably gonna pop back to the resort, just have like an hour to chill, maybe start editing last week's vlog, and then we'll meet at Disney Springs and go from there. Because I think we wanna go over to Character Warehouse, and maybe look at some shoes and stuff. Bye, thank you.
And now, we invite you to relax. Let us do the driving. You'll be home soon.
The main access to the bus stop is steps, but they do have a ramp that goes down that way. In reception, they do have these tables, which are quite nice for like family gaming areas or if you want to do some work. Just down from my room, they have a window out this side, and I've just noticed that looks out to Magic Kingdom. See the Contemporary there, Bay Lake Tower, Space Mountain, and the castle. In getting back to the room and just calling housekeeping because the room hasn't been done and it's coming up to like 4 o'clock, so I figured it probably would have been done by now. I've been advised that they don't do housekeeping every day at Coronado Springs, which, I mean, the pandemic isn't an excuse anymore, I'm afraid. So I'm gonna say that's not good enough. You know, you're paying a few hundred dollars a night to stay in Disney, and it's not like you go to a Hilton or a Marriott or something like that and they do housekeeping every other day. So that's gonna be a negative for Coronado Springs, which is a shame really. Like, it's, you know, you're like, Disney never had this issue before, and like, even if you're staying at All Stars, you're still paying a premium rate to stay in a value resort over staying off property. Anywhere on iDrive you would get housekeeping every day most likely, so yeah, I'm just I'm bitter about it. I'm gonna chill here for a bit and then head over to Disney Springs.
It is Disney Springs time. Had a little rest. Didn't we do a lot?
Hello everyone, and welcome aboard the Walt Disney World Transportation System. We're on our way to Disney Springs. Thanks for riding with us, and have a wonderful time here at Disney Springs.
We're in Uniqlo. That won't be in the vlog. That's a little bit rude.
Thanks.
Jessie's back, looking fabulous as ever.
So they look really nice. I might get that one, you know. And they're always really affordable. Oh, $24.90. Even then, they're quite nice.
In Disney, it'd probably be about $40 though, wouldn't it?
Yeah, the rest.
They've got some embroidered kids' t-shirts in here, which are very lovely. I would have that.
Yes, I like that.
That's lovely. One bite and all your dreams will come true.
Dark, it?
Famous last words. Screen printed tote bag, $29.90, but I think that's really cute and the quality is pretty good as well. It's got like a little popper on it and a pocket inside. Nice. Christmas 2023 is, they're $40 as well. That is lovely. And they've got kid size as well. I like the matching pajamas that you can have. How many coins do we think it is? No price, we'll never know.
$88? $88? You're on your own, mate. Blooming heck.
There's nothing on it. There's nothing. It's a printed.
Nah, not having that.
Little Encanto house. $80. Now Jessie's never washed her hands in here, so I'm gonna find you my favourite one, and then you're gonna grab one of the wooden sticks,
okay,
and get a pea-sized scoop of the light pink one. This one's called Pink Sugar.
Okay.
Can have a little bit more than that. Why not? I know I did. And then you're gonna scrub your hands for 30 seconds. Enjoy.
Ooh, okay, yeah. My hand's already feeling softer. I like this. Okay.
And the smell is something amazing as well. Select bling or stainless steel tumblers, $30 each. Regularly for $50. 50th anniversary one.
And I think it also includes this one as well.
Hmm. I wouldn't like to hold that. It's prickly.
They're very in the US. So if you bought this,
it might be in the US, but they're not in Adam Hattan world. Thank you.
You bought this and you sold it in like a year's time. Probably someone probably paid double for it. Yeah, I had a friend that used to resell
these. Seven. They used to have the dress shop in here, but now it looks like it's become like a Disney merch outlet. They've got some Walt Disney World 50th anniversary hoodies. They are 50% off, or oh no, buy one, get one 50% off. That's not a deal. DJ Pumpkin. Days of Christmas!
How many times do you think they get asked how much they're open all year round? Do you know what I mean? How many times do you think in a day they have to say we're open all year round?
Well, we've walked into a Christmas shop and all we can see is Halloween stuff right now.
That's a lot of decoration for a tea towel.
Mm. A very prominent tea towel. Statement tea towel. That you can only bring out for a month a year. I love how like original, this is like a Disney store from back in the day. Oh yeah!
That is adorable.
I've got one of those. My tree's not big enough to actually have it out, so it's just sat in a box right now. But one day, I'll have a tree big enough and a house and a living room big enough to put it on the floor. We walked into the end room and we just were like, it's really empty in here. And it's the same decoration. We're here.
Oh, it's like a whole...
It's like Vista Village.
Yeah.
Well, should we start the character warehouse and work our way back?
Yes, I think that's the best. That's what we really came here for.
That's what we've come. We've come for the discounted Disney merch. Don't get me wrong. We don't mind picking up something extra. I would like to, if they have a Converse shop, I wouldn't mind having a look for some shoes.
Yeah.
Because I need some different trainers. Granted, I'm wearing my lovely Mickey Mouse numbers from Vans.
I'm so excited. Show me the deal.
It looks full. It's like a Coco shirt.
Yes.
How much?
It's 40 now. Down from 65.
They've got some good stuff in there. Lots of 50th anniversary stuff. So if you didn't manage to find something in the 50th that you want, you might find it in here. The Guardians lamp that they had in the shop as you come off Cosmic Rewind is now here for $90. $19.99 down from $60. Jeez Louise. Wonderful World of Disney Crocs. $29.99. Nothing today. Had a good look around, but it was mostly clothes that weren't in anything other than like a small or a medium. And yeah, there wasn't any homeware pieces that I would have liked. All the Disney Cruise Line ships, which is what I was hoping was in there, but you can't win every time.
I only spent $30 on the jacket.
That was priced at 40.
I know, because in that section there was an extra 30% off.
Oh, so what did you get? Let's show the vlog. You got the little Coco shirt, lovely. That'd be nice for the autumn as well.
Yeah, it will.
Me and Jessie were just talking. They didn't even have any lounge flies in Carrot's Warehouse at all.
Yes,
did you say some of them got their magic bands from there?
Yes, they did. That's what they said. But I couldn't see any when I was in there.
No.
There wasn't it's very accessories at all.
Yeah, it's hit or miss, basically. Like, try your luck. If you're lucky, so be it. We're now gonna make a slow walk over to Cheesecake Factory, which is like a 20-minute walk that way. And hopefully that's not a rain cloud.
It's looking a little like a rain cloud though, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Oh, all hail Pop Bar. It's like, if you want dessert afterwards, this is the place to go. It's like an ice cream popsicle, but then they dip it in like melted chocolate. Ooh. And put like nuts on it if you want.
Okay.
Chef's kiss. Although we are going to the Cheesecake Factory, which is infamous for cheesecake.
Yes, yes. It's a lot of dessert.
And you've never been before?
No, I haven't.
We're going to get there and they're going to go, sorry guys, this is a 2-hour wait. And we're going to be like, I've showed you this before, but we're basically walking out of where American Eagle is. Oh no, it's where Gucci is now. So it was where American Eagle is, that's where Gucci is now. We're basically gonna cross the road here and walk straight. That's what Google Maps says.
It's lovely sunset.
I love a Florida sunset.
It is beautiful.
So we left over there and the Cheesecake Factory is there. Oh, so nice. I would say that's a 10 minute walk, if that.
We haven't crossed the road yet though. Where do you cross the road? Because if you have to walk 10 minutes down to cross the road.
I think this is on this road.
Okay, that's not so bad.
So it should be fine. I think we just follow this.
Okay.
And then it's down there. I wouldn't do this walk when it's dark. There are lights around, but not on this bit of the road.
Mm.
So.
Especially by yourself.
And don't go running in the grass. There's probably snakes in there.
Oh, that hasn't freaked me out at all.
I mean, they're just worms. Just worms.
Just grass snakes.
Grass worms. Looks like we made it. So a lot of people stood out the front though, so this might be a wait. It looked really busy, but they did say only 10-15 minutes, so not too bad. We picked up a menu to have a little browse.
What is this? Are these cocktails?
Oh, I don't mind a cockatiel. This is how big the menu is. If you can't find something on this menu to eat, I'm afraid we're in the wrong country. So we decided what we wanted. We were going to order 3 appetizers and an entree. And we said to our server, so we're looking at 3 appetizers and an entree to share. And he was like, I'm going to stop you right there. The portion sizes are very big here. And I think 3 is a lot. So we're going for the Korean cauliflower and the mac and cheese balls. And then we're going to share a chicken palm pizza style. What drink did you go for, Anya?
Lemonade, the signature lemonade.
Signature. I've gone for a strawberry lemonade. And they're also bringing out bread as well. I love that about American restaurants. You just get bread. Here's some bread. Here's some funky decor. Bread, glorious bread.
It's warm as well.
Ooh, good. Good. I love the sugar rim. Korean fried cauliflower, mac and cheese balls. I'm very excited to get into one of these. I'm just gonna yoink. Ooh, that's fun.
I'm trying to like dip it first.
I will give the Korean cauliflower a 4 out of 5, and the fried macaroni and cheese balls a 5 out of 5. What would you say?
Wait a second. Let me try this again. I'd give both a 5.
Both a 5, yeah. I mean, it was very close to a 5, but I think.
I like the crispiness of it.
Yeah. I'm going to stick with my 4. Because the way I do it is 3 is met the expectation.
Yeah.
4 is good, 5 is excellent.
Okay.
2 is bad, 1 is. Money back, not happy. Well, we don't have to worry about sharing. Do you want to just go for it down the middle? Ooh.
Yeah.
So the key lime pie wasn't able to fit in right now. No. But breakfast tomorrow.
Yeah, in the fridge. Cheeky little breakfast.
Treat yourself.
Exactly.
Overall, out of 5, what are we saying?
We haven't obviously tried the pie yet.
True.
Or the cheesecake, sorry. But I'd say like 4.
I'm gonna go 4 as well. Actually, it wasn't that expensive. Before the tip, it was $75 altogether.
Oh, that's quite good.
For both of us. And we had the nice lemonades.
Mm-hmm. 2 appetizers.
The guy was nice, but it was very busy, so it took a long time to get stuff. Mm-hmm. So that's where they probably lost a point for me tonight.
The chicken palm for me was a bit.
It wasn't as good as I remembered, and I think it might have changed since then.
It was all right. The flavours just weren't very balanced. It was very cheesy, very garlicky.
I would agree.
Almost was an Alfredo more than it was chicken parm, if that makes sense.
Yeah. The mac and cheese balls, though, were...
amazing.
Loved them. We're going to pop over to the... there's some shops over there. There's a Disney gift store. See if that's open. If not, we're going to head to Publix and just get some bits and bobs before we head back.
We're now going into the very official looking Disney gifts.
I feel like I've walked into a nightmare. You know, like something's just a bit off. And if it's not the merchandise itself, it's the radio from 1996 that still has a tape cassette player on the side. They have got suitcases in here, so I suppose if you were looking to like find a cheap suitcase to take stuff home that you'd bought.
Really, really big one, $120.
Average size one, $100. I mean, they're not cheap. How much is this? $100. I mean, it's cheaper than obviously buying a Disney one, but even then. Moving on, we're gonna walk to Publix. Should we walk? You happy to walk?
Yeah, I'm happy to walk.
Yeah, we'll walk. We're gonna stick on this side because I think on the other side there wasn't lights, but on this side there was, so I was paying attention. Get some snacks and call it a night.
Ooh.
So there's the Disney stuff that I was talking about.
Oh, yeah.
A glazed pumpkin donut. I want like little pastry bits, like croissants or something. Muffins. I might go yogurts, you know.
That's very healthy yogurts. Of you.
Well, I will get the M&M ones, so that's not particularly healthy, but you know. Got some cute little key rings here that are $5 each. Am I a 12-year-old trapped in a 30-year-old's body? Absolutely. Do I care?
No. Why should you care? Why should you care?
What are they going to do? What's going to happen? Back in the room. Oh, what a lovely evening. And what a long day. Considering I've been up since 5:30 a.m. and it's now coming up to 11 p.m. I'm ready for bed. But just want to say thank you very much for watching. When this video goes out, the Christmas collection general sale will be launching on Friday the 10th of November. So if you want to go and get yourself some swag, like the Christmas morning jumper. Can I do this with one hand? Ta-da. Yeah. Oh, you can't really see it. Anyway, adamhattan.com if you want to go and check that out. In the meantime, I hope you'll tune in for next week. I'm going to Magic Kingdom with Sam, Dale, and Jesse, and then we're also going to Halloween Horror Nights at Universal Studios. I'm so excited. So I love coming this time of year, in all honesty. Hate horror films, but love Horror Nights. Bit my tongue. There you go to bed. Right, like if you enjoyed it, subscribe to the future stuff. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.